Guys, it's been a long road to get here.
Alright, okay, I will.
And this is absolutely what Herping meant to me.
A toda esta gente, que por mí todo el año es 420, la moña violeta y cruyente, enrolla otro bate que llegó Clemente y métele con candela, Bonnie, métele con candela, el creepy está en la cartera, billetes hasta en la suela, yeah, baby, como la nota, trépate, ella yo me arrebaté, yeah, la cartera Gucci o Supreme, cabrones que me tiran y no tienen toque pa' subirse al ring, hoy ando medio travieso, tu mujer quiere de mi aderezo, porque
been a long road to get here, and this is absolutely what Herping dreams are made of. Myself and some boys, Dane, Miles, Justin, and Andres, are off trail in the Guatemalan highlands, way up in the cloud forest, way away from civilization, and we're looking at Bothriacus aurifer, the yellow-blotched palm viper. This is such an incredible snake and such an incredible species. It only lives up here in these highlands, in these cool, misty forests full of epiphytes and tree ferns. It's like another world. And finding this snake is unreal. I think that I've been dreaming about this moment ever since I saw a photo of this species in a book when I was probably 10 years old. And ever since, I've just been hoping for a day like this, traipsing through the jungle, looking for arboreal pit vipers in one of the coolest places I've ever been. I can't really say much more. This snake speaks for itself. We're gonna take some photos of this guy, release them, and, you know, get back to herping and hopefully find some more really cool stuff.
En el ambiente, hoy se quema la taganga y 420, ando más azotado que los timbales de estos puentes, brilla, ya, ya, erro la que prende el filique, de aquí salgo en el machi bien volado haciendo huelique, aquí las moñas son verdes como el Guasón y Harley, hoy vamos a quemar todo el mundo a nombre de Bob Marley, la cartera en Louis es 100% en piel, y adentro tengo la moña, la paca y la cartier, que tu gato lo coja suave y no se vaya a envolver, andamos ready, no la dejamos caer.
Tell them once again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Four. Yeah. Why, oh, yeah. Why, oh, yeah. Los blones, lo canten que prendan los blones. Vamos a quemar como se supone. Aquí todo el mundo va a quemar. Pero ya, ya, ya. Y pa'l carajo la mente sana. Yo lo que quiero es marihuana.
Sitting at a biosphere in the central highlands of Guatemala, up in the cloud forests, and this place is incredible. And when I say incredible, I mean I'm surrounded by 30-foot-tall tree ferns. There's a quetzal in the tree over there.
Oh no, he moved. There was a quetzal in the tree over there a minute ago. Oh, there's actually some. Yeah, there's some really cool bird. Sorry, there's some really cool little birds flitting around. I think they're Guatemalan tyrannulets. This place is amazing. You might be wondering how I ended up in Guatemala. Well, a couple months ago, a friend of mine shot me a message saying, hey, trying to put together a trip to go find some really cool species in Guatemala. And of course I said yes. And now here we are in the cloud forests, surrounded by incredible species. But we're not staying in the cloud forests. We're actually gonna be hopping around the country a little bit, going to check out some other really interesting preserves and hopefully find some really cool species. This trip is already fantastic, but I'm really excited to put together a really cool video for you showing off some of these amazing creatures in this amazing place.
Dylan here.
Now, we've moved on to a spiny dry forest, and there is a big old Crotalus cymus up there, and I'm gonna go up and get him.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Saunders here spotted this animal in a wash-like habitat here in the valleys of Guatemala, and he's gonna get this boy out. Or it's going to dart in a hole and we're all going to be mad at him.
Get him away from that burrow. Yeah.
He has the boy.
I'm here if you need help.
Yep, I'm just, hey, yep. Move out. You're good, you're good. I'm back. I'm not looking at where you
yep.
are.
Yep, you're clear.
Camera's all the way.
Wow. That is a snake.
That is a hell of a snake.
Hey guys, this is Crotalus cymus. And oh my god.
It's a really cool pattern. It's huge.
Oh, wow.
Sponsored by Raptor Energy Drink.
Raptor Energy Drink.
Yeah, it's the camera bowl.
Oh yeah. Oh. Very cool.
That is a hell of a snake. Bananas and blow.
guys, we've moved into a different spot. Nice little mountain range in a national park. We're here with some rangers, and we've been having a fantastic night. And I realize I haven't really talked about anything. Right here, we have an eyelash pit viper, Buthriacus schlegeli. This is actually our third one of the night. We've also gotten cat-eyed snakes, a tropical swamp snake, parrot snakes, cone-headed iguanas, a lot of stuff. It's been one of the best nights for herping that I have ever had. But I wanted to talk about this little guy. So this is in the same genus as the Buthriacus aurifer that we caught earlier, but different species, lives in different habitat, and it looks completely different. And the coolest thing about them is they've got these little ridges above their eyes, which is where they get the name eyelash pit viper. This is a species that I've been seeing in books and in photos since I was little and have always wanted to find. I've tried for them 3 times before and have failed every time. And so I'm really happy to have these little animals finally within my sights. Let me take some pictures of this guy and let him go.
Wagwan Faruko. Yeah man, what you mean? Chow Mitcha. Make him bring some girl then. Check out, take care of the liquor. Alright.
Style! 6 de la mañana bebo el sol salir. Prendo un fili pa' empezar el día bien chilling. Ya activé el combo y la baby vienen por ahí. Mientras engancho el jet y descapo todo el jet. Salió el remake de Playa Valdez. Puerto Rico activa. Vamos a la playa a pasarla bien con los friends. Y si tú quieres venir, pues ven tú también. Playa, ya tengo mi short y mi toalla. Y el que no quiere venir, pues que no vaya. Playa, a pasarla bien con los friends. Y si tú quieres venir, pues ven tú también. Playa, ya tengo mi short y mi toalla. Y el que no quiere venir, pues
oye, todo el mundo pa' la guagua. Esta noche nos fuimos pa' la guagua.
Spot, a new mountain range in a different part of Guatemala. And here we have two incredible snakes that look pretty different, but they're actually the same species. These are Porphyrium nasutum, and here we've got a tiny little male who's a little jumpy, and I don't want him to run away, and a big, beautiful female. Now this species is displaying something known as sexual dimorphism, which means that the sexes look different. Two, morphism, is a form or a morph. And it's really cool that they display these two different forms, but they're both still incredibly cryptic. This is a species that has evolved to look exactly like the leaf litter that it lives in. And their crypsis is actually so good that all of us walked past both of them, and our guide ended up seeing them after we'd already gone past, and then called us back like the dumb gringos we were. Now, this is our last night here in Guatemala. Next, we're gonna go to Belize, but so far, it's just been an incredible trip. So good, in fact, that we could go out tonight and see nothing, and it still probably would have been the best trip I've ever been on. I'm so happy to have been here. Thank you to all the people who were involved. These are some great snakes. I've been wanting to see one of these for so long. We're gonna let him go and hopefully go find something else. So, in that last video where I was talking about the rainforest hognose vipers, the Porphyrium, I said something along the lines of, if we find nothing else tonight, it will still have been a great trip. Well, that didn't happen. So right here we have Atropoides mexicanus, the Mexican jumping viper. This is a really cool little species. They're very short and stout, but they have these big heads, these big fangs, and they
reach out and grab stuff. He's just a little guy, probably last year's baby, so I don't think I'm in much danger of him jumping out and grabbing me. He's also being really well behaved. Most venomous snakes like this, if you're not messing with them and prodding with them, they'll just coil up or try and get away. Really happy to have found this snake. Really wanted to see this species. And here I am looking at a beautiful animal.
Hey everyone. It is my last day of the trip. We're currently in Belize in a hotel room. I'm packing up to go to the airport. This has been such an incredible trip, and I have been so thankful to all the people who helped us get here, Justin, Dane, Miles, Andres, and Pablo, and Señor Don Hill. So many amazing people made this happen. This was such a cool experience. I'm really sad to leave, but you know, you gotta go home eventually. And I am confident that I will come back here and I will do this again. So, thanks for watching. I'm gonna keep herping. Might not be in Guatemala, might not be in a video, but I'm gonna keep doing it. All right, bye.
Stick this.
Big one.
Hey boys, what we got?
Variable coral snake.
Dice demo?
Are you filming?
Oh, yeah, you're on video.
Hey, this is a coral snake. Hey guys, Dylan here. This is a variable coral cord.
Welcome to the jungle.
This is a coral snake.
It's got a little tail.
I'm an idiot.
You'll notice, by the way, the yellow touches the red.
So for the record, for those kids at home, this tube is a little fatter than
we
would want to use.
And that's why
we normally would use a smaller tube, but this is all we have, so we're still playing it safe though. We're keeping a close eye on it.
Is there a way to open its mouth? I think it's not a coral snake.
Wait?
What would it be?
Pleocercus elapoides.
It doesn't look like
circus.
Yeah, wait, something's up with those pupils.
Yeah. Wait, say it again. What is it? What's going on?
I think it might not be a coral snake. It might be a colubrid, Pleocercus elapoides.
Yeah, and the way it identifies the tail that's missing.
Yeah, that would.
The tail is not missing. It's just stubby.
Wait, leave it like that.
Hey, let's get out of the ink. Wait, no, we're good. We're good.
You wanna? Yeah.
Saunders, if we misidentify it, you're not allowed to show any of this.
Yeah,
video.
Seriously, like
that. It's embarrassing.
Cut the film. Its head looks.
I'm showing all of it.
Open its mouth, maybe. Yeah, I'm almost positive it's not a coral.
Oh, I'm so sketched.
Yeah, no, dude, look at
it's not a coral. Because corals have
no coral, no fangs.
Well,
they're rear fang, aren't they?
yeah, they can only bite you between the webbing of your toes.
No, I meant like the mimic.
No fangs?
Yeah, that's colubrid.
Yeah. Oh man, I'm scared.
That's terrifying.
Yeah, that is a good ass mimic.
Wow. Hey guys.
Oh wait, yeah, fuck. I'm dumb.
Hey guys, so real quick, the red and yellow kill a fellow rhyme absolutely does not work here. This is not a coral snake, but it red is touching yellow. Incredibly convincing mimic. Wow.
Yeah, you ever like look at the fangs and still not trust it?
Wow.
Yeah, that's how I'm feeling right now. I mean, but its body shape is different. It's not shaped like a coral.
It's like
fast that it really looked like
a
coral.
Its head is not right.
I mean, it even not moving, it looks like a coral.
Yeah. Oh, I still
cool.
Don't trust
okay,
it.
We get to photograph this thing.
Yeah.
Holy
yeah, that's actually.